Okay. Moving with the next topic, that is free space management. Every time, whenever any allocations of related to any files or folders are freed, that space has to be reused, else it will be a waste of memory. So in order to reuse that space from the secondary storage or from the hard disk drive, there are various methods, and this reusing of the free space and this reusing of the memory that was allocated to any file or folder previously, or any of the documents or any of the applications previously, and it has now been freed, and usage of that is called as free space management. And there are various methods to manage this free space allocation to various other applications. So out of which, the first one is a bit vector. So basically, what do you mean by free space management? Free space management is when any other files or folders or applications or whatever installations that you are doing on a hard drive or onto an operating system needs to know where the free space is, needs to know where the application can be installed, and this free space has to be notified somewhere. So how does the operating system know whether the free space is at a particular location or no? So to know that, we follow various methods, out of which one of them is bit vector. So here, bit vector follows a strategy where each block is represented by a single bit. Representation by single bit means what? So if the block is free, then it is then the block is stored with the value of 1. So if the block is not free, then it is stored with the value of 0. So we'll take an example here. Suppose that this is our hard drive. This is our hard drive where I have different blocks. Okay. So the block is having numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 16. Okay. So now, suppose that there is a file called as G. Okay. So, and this file is allocated the blocks of 2, 4, 15 and 16. Maybe it is kind of an index allocation. By looking at the allocation blocks, you can say that it is not continuous. Might be it is a linked allocation or a index allocation. Okay, so the locations or the block numbers 2, 4, 15 and 16. So 2, 4, 15 and 16. So are they free now? So they are not free. So if they are not free, according to the bit vector representation, if they are not free, they have to be filled with the value of 0. So actually it is not filled here with 0. There will be a memory allocation table where it verifies which memory is free, which memory is empty. Okay, so this memory allocation table will be in this format. I am just giving you for reference. So 1, 2, so 14 15 and 16. So looking at this, is 1 free? Yes, 1 is free. So bit vector is 1 here. Then is 2 free? No, 2 is not free. Is 3 free? Yes. 4? No. 5? Yes, 6. So from 6 to 14, all are having value of 1. So 15 and 16 are having value of 0. Okay, so now since the file is holding the blocks of 2, 4, 15 and 16, only the blocks 2, 4, 15 and 16 are holding the bit vector value 0. The remaining blocks which are not holding any of the files or which are not holding any of the contents are being marked as 1, indicating that these are the memory locations which are free, such that the operating system can access these at any point of time. So this is what is known as free space management using bit vector. Moving on with the next free space management technique known as linked list. Okay, so again we'll consider the same thing. So we have a file called as zip, which is holding 2, 4, 15 and 16. So if I want to manage the free space using linked list now, so what do you mean by a linked list? Linked list is the one where the previous block is holding the address of the next block, or the previous content is holding the address of the next content. So with respect to this diagram, so we'll plot the linked list table. Okay. So what is happening here is I have a free space location, free space location and a pointer. Okay, so considering this, here it is not marked with either 0 or 1 to indicate the free space. Here the pointer is holding the free space value. See here, look here. So is the first block free? Yes, the first block free. So the pointer is holding the address or the block number of the next free block. So which is the next free block? 3. Okay, so which is the next free location? 3. So what is 3 holding? The address of the next free block. Which is the next free block now? 5. Okay, so now free location is 5. 5 is holding what now? 6. 6 is holding 7. So this continues to 13. So 13 holds 14. So is 15 and 16 free? No, 15 and 16 are not free. 15 and 16 are not free. So the last free memory block that is available is 14. So free memory block available is 14. So every free block contains a pointer which is holding the address of the next free block. Here, and this gives the operating system a table or an address which is where the files and folders can be stored, or the free space can be allocated to any of the required files, any of the required allocations. Okay, so the next one is grouping. So the next one is grouping. Okay, we'll again consider the same diagram. So what do you mean by grouping? Grouping is to bring the most of the contents together. So what contents are we talking about? We are talking about the free space that is being present on the hard disk drive. Okay, so now I have a pointer with a block number. Okay. So now consider again the file G is holding 2, 4, 15 and 16. They are marked. Okay. So now which is the first free location? First free location is 1. Is there any nearby that can be grouped? I mean continuous allocation that can be grouped? No. It holds only one block which is free. It holds only one block that is free. That is pointer 1, the block 1 is holding the address of 1. Which is the next one? 3. So can the next one be bypassed? No. How many blocks are free? 1. Okay. So the next one is 5. So the next one is 5. Okay. How many blocks are free now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So pointer with block number 5, it is holding the address from 5 to 14. So how many blocks are free? 10. So the 10 together are stored in the block 5. The addresses are stored in the block 5. Okay. So this is what is known as grouping. Or this can also be done as the pointer one is hold, the block 1 is holding 1. I mean the pointer with block number 1 is holding 1. 3 is again holding 1. 5 to 7 I can group, or 5 to any number. I am just grouping in a random manner. So 5, 6, 7, 3. Okay, 7 is the holding of the next block number, which is again having a group. So suppose that 8 is having a group. 8 is having, here 5 was having a group. So next 8 is having a group from 8 to 12. So 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So it is 5. So 8 is holding the next content, 12, which is having a group again. So from 12 to 14, 12, 13 and 14, 3. So this is also called as grouping. This is also called as grouping. Okay. So this is how free space management is done by grouping. Okay. Now in counting. Counting is usually most of the time dealt with continuous memory management deallocation. Suppose that if I have a file named as tr, which is getting deallocated from 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, then here 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this is the content. And so 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is the file, is the location where TR file is being stored. Then assume that one more file called as zip stored at 13 and 14, which is, this is getting deallocated. This is still allocated. So counting is, suppose that if 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 6, 7 and 8 are free, are getting free, then the block 1, which was initially holding only these three counts. These three counts means what? 1, 2 and 3. This block, the block 1 is telling the operating system that it has three continuous memory. It is 1, 2 and 3. Now which file is getting deallocated? 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So now the block 1 will be updated with count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, since 13 and 14 is allocated to the next file. So from 1 to 12 is the updated count. The block 1 is stored with the count value where it can be, where a new file can be stored. So this count indicates this block is telling the operating system that if at all if you want to store any file continuously, then I have 12 memory blocks available with me. So you can store any file with me which is not exceeding block 12. So 12 continuous blocks I can provide you to store any file. So this is what is known as counting. This is what is known as counting. So these are the different methods for free space management.